ideas. In last class, we completed the exercise 14.2. 1, 2, 3 sums we completed. Now, fourth sum. See the fourth sum. The height of 50 students measured to the nearest centimeter have been found to be as follows. Okay. 50 students oda heights they are giving. Okay. And like this they gave. Represent the data given above by a grouped frequency distribution table taking the class interval as 160 to 165, 165 to 170, etc. Okay. Here also 165 will not be included. In next interval only 165 will be included. Then what can you conclude about their height from the table? About their height from the table means which one height is more one they are having, like that they, you want to write. Okay, this is a homework for you. You have to form the frequency distribution table and write the answer for second one. Second one answer is எந்த இன்டர்வலுக்கு அதிகமாக வருதோ அதை எழுதணும். ஓகேவா? நவ் ஃபிஃப்த் சம். எ ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ் வாஸ் கண்டக்டட் டு ஃபைண்ட் அவுட் த கான்சன்ட்ரேஷன் ஆஃப் சல்ஃபர் டை ஆக்சைடு இன் த ஏர் பாட்ஸ் பர் மில்லியன் ஆஃப் பிபிஎம் ஆஃப் சட்டைன் சிட்டி. த டேட்டா அப்டைட் ஃபார் 30 டேஸ் இஸ் அஸ் ஃபாலோஸ். ஓகே, ஒரு சிட்டியில் இருக்க சல்ஃபர் டை ஆக்சைடோட கான்சன்ட்ரேஷன், அதாவது ஒரு ஏரில் ஏரில் வந்து நமக்கு நிறைய வேப்பர்ஸ் இருக்கும், அதில் வந்து சல்ஃபர் டை ஆக்சைடு வந்து எவ்வளோ பர்சன்டேஜ், அதாவது ஒவ்வொரு நாளைக்கு எவ்வளோ பர்சன்டேஜ் இருக்குது அப்படிங்கிறத டேபிள் பண்ணி கொடுத்துருக்காங்க. இதை வந்து நம்ம என்ன பண்ண போகிறோம், மேக் ஏ குரூப்டு ஃப்ரீக்வன்சி டிஸ்ட்ரிபியூஷன் டேபிள் ஃபார் திஸ் டேட்டா வித் கிளாஸ் இன்டர்வல் ஆஸ் 0.00 டு 0.04, 0.04 to 0.08 and so on. Okay, for how many days was the concentration of sulfur dioxide more than 0.11 parts per million? Parts per million, they gave ppm equal, that the explanation is parts per million. Okay, now I am going to form a frequency distribution table. I wrote the data whatever they gave. Now I am going to form a frequency distribution table. Okay, that interval they gave 0.00 to 0.04, again 0.04 to 0.08, 0.08 to 44 they are included, so 0.12, then 0.12 to 0.16, then 0.16 to 0.20, then 0.20 to 0.24. up to this I wrote. If we need, we will continue the intervals. Okay, now I am going to refer for 0.04 to 0.00 to 0.04. that means 0.00, 0.01, 0.02 as well as 0.03. okay, now we will refer the data. See here, 1, next 2, 3, 4. So we have 4. Next 0.04 to 0.08, that means 0.04, 0.05, 0.06, 0.07. I am going to refer the data. Now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So here we have 9. Next one is 0.8 to 0.12. So 0.08, 0.09, 0.10, 0.11. Okay. Now I wrote for knowing your reference only, I wrote for these two steps. No need these steps on that. So I am going to directly refer the data. See here. Now 7, here also 8, one more we have, so here 9. So we have 9 here also. 0.12 to 0.16, sorry, 0.12 to 0.16, like this only we want to tell you, no? So I am going to refer now. See here, up to 15. So 1, 2, 2 only we have. Here it will come 2. Next one, 0.16 to 0.20. See here, 1, 2, 3, here 4. So we have 4, balance 0.20 to 0.24. See here. So nothing here and all. 1, 2, 2 only, so 2. If you add this fully, you will get 30. See here, 4 plus 9, 10, 13, 13 plus 9, 20, 22, 22 plus 2, 24, 24 plus 4, 26, 26. 2 plus 4, 6, 7, 8, 6, 17, 20, 26, 30. So, this is the frequency distribution table for 5th sum. They are asking, now we will refer the question. They are asking, for how many days was the concentration of sulfur dioxide more than 0.11? Okay, see here 0.11 means from here it will come. So 2 plus 4, 6 plus 2, 8. So the answer for second question is 8 days. Okay, that's all. 5th sum is completed. Now we will move to the next sum. 6th sum is, 3 coins were tossed 30 times simultaneously. Each time the number of hits occurring was not denoted as was noted down as follows. Okay, 30 coins vandu 30 times vandu or 3 coins vandu toss pannikite irukanga. Adula vandu appo first time the 3 coins toss pannumbodhu or zero head, adhu endha headume varala, ellathilayume tail da vandhathu, so zero. So second time toss pannumbodhu ore ore head vandhathu, so one. Adhu mari adhu vandu frequency kuduthirukanga. Prepare a frequency distribution table for a data given above. Okay, shall we form that frequency distribution table? I wrote the data here. Number of hits, 3 coins they are toasting. So number of hits, how many times? 0, 1, 2, or 3. Okay, now I am referring the data. Here it will not come in interval because 0 means 0 only, 0 to 1 like this and all, it will not come. So I am referring the how many zeros we have. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. How many zeros we have? 6 zeros. So 6. Again, 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So 1 we have 10 times. Again 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So how many times? 9. 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times. How many times we have? 5. So if you add, you will get 30. This is the expected frequency distribution table. That's all there. Do the homework. First time I think so. 4th sum I gave homework for you. Complete the table. Okay. Thank you, dears.